Yeah, and we're back. So let's have a look here. What did I miss? So yeah, cool from a technical editing hack, also really shitty from how it's being implemented scenario. Yeah, exactly. So basically what these guys are doing is they're implementing it as if they're actual content viewers, people who are engaging with YouTubers. And they're not. Closer. And they're turning like inactive accounts into bots to do the same. It's really a bizarre trend. Like, it's an alarming trend in terms of like what that means for content creators. It's like, what do you have to be careful of? Like, what have you got to be careful of in terms of like what is? I mean, let's be friends. I like the content. Blah blah blah. It's like, and if they're getting smarter, it's like, when are you going to be able to discern which of these is a fake profile and which one is not? Because let's be honest, it's going to be harder and harder to do that. But and the more clever they get, the more difficult it's going to be. And it's like, it's interesting, but at the same time, it's like, why? What's the greater purpose of what they're doing? It's what I'd like to know. I'd like to know what their objective is. Like, sure, it's to harvest these accounts, but why? Seems to be artificial. Oh, yeah, I see. That's interesting. That is really interesting. It's an interesting point of discussion as well, because at what point do you, how do you implement? Like, what if somebody does legitimately make that comment about somebody? Like, what if somebody does legitimately say, hey, let's be friends, or really liked your content, or we should collaborate or something. What if that is a legit comment? How do you then determine whether that comment's been, if from an algorithm perspective, you can't just filter out everybody who says that, because there are plenty of genuine people who might say things like that on a video. So it's like, how do you, you can't filter that out. It does seem crazy. I mean, I would say the lengths people will go to is what amazes me. Well, yeah, there's that. There's that too. The algorithms are kind of broken. What I find interesting as well is that how platforms choose to how platforms decide who is to be deplatformed for their views on the world and who is not. Without naming names, like I just find it very interesting how that decision is made, and it's like, and what if that is based on bias or fact? What if that is based on the perceived stance of the platform if they don't do it? So who are they afraid of?
Well struck.
Things like
defeating
that.
The enemy's champions will break their morale and send them scurrying back to the shadows.
And what it is that they're probably more afraid of advertisers pulling out if they don't seem to be vetting channels and vetting people. But you've got to be careful that what you vet and what you do doesn't look like you're pushing an agenda. And sometimes it does. Or pushing less an agenda but more a narrative. Which can be problematic when you look at it that way, because I think they're afraid of the outrage mobs scaring away advertisers, like we saw with PewDiePie. All that guy did was he said... We know what he said. We know what he did. But, if you ask me, it seems like it was a genuine misstep. He just said it, didn't think about what he was saying, it's backfired. He knows he screwed up. He knows full well that he screwed up. But it's like, he doesn't make any apologies for that. He knows what he did. But I just don't think that... I think the reaction was disproportionate. Yeah, they're afraid of an adpocalypse. They're afraid of an adpocalypse. I get that. If a lot of your revenue comes from advertising, you would be afraid of that. It does make sense. But also, at what point is it unfair to deplatform somebody just because you disagree with them? Like, for me, it's less about what should be done from a business perspective, which I get it. If it's just business, then I get that. But if we look at it from the perspective of you shouldn't hold a bias, and you shouldn't hold, you know, especially things if they kicked him. Yeah, exactly, man. So they couldn't afford to lose him. And I think it was a genuine mistake. I don't think it was racially motivated. I don't think it's hate speech. Yeah, I know we know what he said and we know it's not okay. But we also know that that's not the kind of person that he is. Yeah, exactly. So, for example, you've got NordVPN. They're a good one for that. You've got Raid Shadow Legends. They're another good one for that. It's your boy, Raid Shadow Legends. And I love that. I love the fact that Raid Shadow Legends just do not care. They're just like, hey, listen, do you want to play our mobile game, Raid? But first, it's your boy, Raid Shadow. Can you imagine, like, it turns out I end up getting a Raid Shadow Legends sponsor when I start big on YouTube? And then, so I've just been memeing on, it's your boy Raid Shadow Legends, and then can you imagine it happens? Ah, God. That'd be hilarious. favorite types of humor are obnoxious humor and irony. So, you know. I do enjoy irony, though. I really enjoy irony. Right, we got about another 12% to go on this. My Wi-Fi just dropped. Best be heading off, matey. Video research. Yeah, no worries, man. Thank you so much for checking me out. You rock for hanging out with us, man. Thank you so much. Much appreciated and much love, man. You take care of yourself, and I hope to see you around soon on here. Come hang out whenever you feel like you can. See you next time, dude. Thank you very much. So it should be Monday night if you're around. Thank you, mate. Thank you so much for coming, and thank you for the support. Thanks for the love.
To target something first.
Five 5% more on this. Black Warden Rockthos. I'm probably gonna have to kill this by myself anyway, but that's so annoying. The Horde player killed me knowing that I'm trying to kill the boss. Well, it's dead now, yeah. List the group. Just gonna wait, try and form a group, because I could try and do this myself, but I'm gonna get ganked. I know I am.
Too far away.
So I'm just concentrating on this. Why leave the party? Long fight this. You're doing it by yourself in your undergear, you just gotta keep kiting. Don't stand in the crap. We're a pretty good number here with almost doing it. everyone's just gonna go yell, aren't they, and stuff. He's gonna go down.
It is done. Target. The enemy forces are routed and in retreat. Return to Rab'Gahan when you can.
Go to Rab'Gahan. We did it. That was a pain in the ass, but we did it. And we got some wrist plates. 440 wrist plates.
Hail, adventurer.
Champion! Mother may have found a way to restore the Forge of Origination. Meet us at the Chamber of Heart as soon as you can.
So we've got to go back to Silithus. I like how you can see the sword and the towers from here. Like, so if you look, when you're looking up, you can see the Sword of Sargeras, and you can also see all this. So we're just going to get all the way back there now. We're going to be cutting this soon anyway, so...
Must get closer.
Get back! Let's hear what Mother has to say.
Forge operating at reduced capacity. Recommendation: reroute power from compatible Titan facilities.
So the forge was not damaged beyond repair. How fortuitous. It is unlike N'Zoth to resort to brute force.
All of the other forges are working full-time to protect Azeroth. Is there anywhere else we can get that power?
Schematics indicate compatibility between Forge of Origination and Engine of Nalak Shah.
That's it then. Looks like we're heading to Pandaria.
It seems our fates are intertwined. Learn from the past. Look to the future.
Accessing breeding database. Hello. Do you require experimentation? Contamination levels nominal.
Okay, so that's how you purify.
Farewell protocol activated.
Our world needs us, champion. For Azeroth! I'll meet you at the entrance to the vaults, champion.
So the next step is we're gonna go to Kunlai. So what I'm gonna do is, given the time, I'm gonna cut it there for tonight, guys. Thank you so much for watching. You guys all fucking rock. Tune in again on Monday for more streaming. Stay safe, stay indoors. You guys are the absolute best, and you make this stream so much more worthwhile. And just take care, guys. You guys rock. Thank you.